Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, and here to just kind of talk about the fact that I've been vegan, although I have had a lot more vegetarian days than I would have liked, for about 4 years now. So, March 29th, that's the anniversary date for my veganism, came and went this year. Like, it just kind of came and went. You know, usually I like to celebrate my, you know, it's like a birthday for me. You know, it's where I really changed so much about myself, this decision to not partake in any animal products or try not to as much as possible was such a profound decision for me, you know, and it had a big impact on my everyday lives. This is one thing, you know, this philosophy of mine, there's one thing where much of the decision I'm making is conscious, you know, it's an identity that I consciously have to make an effort for. It's an identity that I chose for myself. That's what I think it makes it a powerful thing, being vegan or being vegetarian. You know, because some of my other identities are not even really what I chose to be. It's just what I am or what people considered me as. You know, the identity that I'm Korean, whatever. You know, the fact that I was born in Korea and I look like this makes me Korean. Did I choose to be that way? Not really. The fact that I'm, you know, a guy, or straight, or whatever, these are identities that are just kind of happenstance or circumstance. I didn't choose them. You know, if I could be a god of my own life, like, would I have chosen this way? I'm not really sure how to answer that question. But I do know that this was a choice of mine. You know, I could choose to continue the way I was raised or grown up, but I chose to not be part of a system which I think is pretty unethical for me. To really live out my values to the fullest way I can is how I came to be, well, not how I came, but how I continue to be a vegan. You know, not eating meat or milk or dairy and trying not to have products that involve suffering of animals or killing of animals or exploitation of animals and things like that. But it goes beyond that. Anyway, this fourth year wasn't really a big thing. Usually, like I said, my first, second, and third year Hallmark, I celebrated. You know, I went to a vegan restaurant and just kind of went on a splurge, spent some money, and just enjoyed myself and celebrated the fact that I was able to do this. And that's a big thing. Vegan restaurants are really expensive, especially in New York City, where restaurants are already expensive, by the way, but vegan restaurants even more so, because there's a lower demand for them, so there's a kind of a price, that extra price that we pay, I think, for not just being in the New York City, but also like the lower demand, we have to make up for that by the higher price, which is kind of sucky. But like, I still like to support, you know, those kind of restaurants for even existing. You know, for having that, like, you know, there's a restaurant or a place that has a philosophy similar to mine, that kind of passion and ambition. So I like to support them. But this year, like, just kind of went by. My fourth year as a vegan, unfortunately, I had a lot more vegetarian days than I would have liked. And you know, it was kind of hard for me. I was working as a political canvasser at one point. And I was making a lot of money, and so we would have, like, those pizza days, you know, pizza nights, free pizza for all the workers. Like, it was hard for me to refuse, so of course I had that. There's also, you know, pizza days that we have at the high school that I intern at. So, pizza is one of those things that I can't eat unless I make it myself without cheese, or, you know, I go to a vegan restaurant and they do, you know, vegan pizzas, which are interesting, actually. I've had one vegan pizza that this is a digression, but I've had one vegan pizza that didn't use cheese at all. Like, because a lot of vegan restaurants, they try to do like the other kind of plant-based cheese, or soy-based cheese, or almond-based cheese, or what have you. But they didn't use cheese at all. This was just like just tomato sauce, the way I usually like to make it. I really liked it. It was expensive though. It was like this tiny little pie for $8. But like I said, vegan food is expensive in New York City. This year just kind of went by. Like, March 29th happened. I'm like, oh, today's March 29th. Oh shit! Like today marks the fourth year. I'm a vegan. So like that took me a little back. Like how nonchalant I was about it. I didn't really celebrate it. Just kind of went by. Like, I think it, by this point, what's a powerful thing is that it's just become a thing that I am. It's not really a thing that I'm, like, so proud of or so celebratory. It's just like, yeah, this is something that I have to be, that I'm choosing to be, that I've been for a while now. I think there are going to be some hallmark years now. My fifth year, I'm probably going to celebrate in a big way. If it gets to be like my 10th year, that's going to be a big deal. But I think it's no longer that big of a deal anymore that I'm able to continue doing this. The second year was such a big deal that I like made it to that point, you know. And I had my moments of being tempted and whatnot. But like the temptation no longer really exists for me anymore. Like the days that I'm vegetarian are just the days that I do it out of social convenience, you know. And people who are like, you know, who prepared this food for me, or there is free food to be had, but the only way to eat that is like to not be so strict as a vegan and be vegetarian, you know. So those are the days I guess actually have become vegetarian. Now there's still a minority. I think my fourth year as a whole, I was more vegan than vegetarian. I think my vegetarian days are like, I don't know, about 20 of those. So 20 out of the whole year, I was vegetarian, I think. That's still a very small percentage of the year, but still a lot more than any of my previous years as a vegan. So I think I have a more like malleable or a kind of a more lax attitude towards this. I'm not so strictly like, I have to be doing this. I'm more accepting of myself, I think, throughout this journey. And I think that's usually kind of what happens throughout this journey. It's also very challenging in a way, because it's once I start being just like not being so nonchalant, there's a danger there that I can kind of regress back to not even being vegetarian, but just being, you know, something else altogether. One thought I had when I wanted to make this video about me being 4 years is, you know, there are questions that we all must ask ourselves, even if you're vegan or vegetarian. You know, I don't necessarily think that being a vegan or vegetarian puts me on a moral high ground or anything. I still think there are questions that we all are accountable for. For example, if I get a salad, right? So I still have to ask the question, who suffered to make this food possible? To make it possible that I have this food in front of me. Who suffered? That still is a very important question, because no matter what, people still suffered to make this food possible. There were immigrant workers that worked hard in the field. There were pesticides that would probably use no matter how much conscious effort you make it, there is some suffering involved. And we have to be aware of that. And so my philosophy in being vegan is to make sure that it's the least harmful possible. Not that it has no harm in it, but the least harm possible. And that's what veganism is to me. It is the least harm possible. Least harm in that no animals are killed. So there is that suffering. There's that suffering. No human workers get their arms cut off trying to cut a meat into pieces, because the butchering industry, the meat factory industry, is the one with like the most human injuries and the most emotional pain for human workers, right? Not just for animals. Animals suffer, sure, but the humans who have to kill animals just so that you don't have to, they suffer as well. So who suffers when I'm eating this thing? Who suffers to make this shirt possible that I'm wearing? You know, that's also something to be mindful of. I'm also vegan for not just for ethical reasons, for environmental reasons as well. You know, what kind of damage did this make to the environment that we're living in, to the local community that we're living in, to make it possible? And that's also a yes answer to anything that you're doing. Everything that you have, a book, the shirt you're wearing, an earring you're wearing, you know, they had an impact to the environment. Somebody suffered to make that possible. And some part of the environment was damaged to make that possible. So that's also a question that everyone should be held accountable for. And I strongly believe that. This isn't to bring everyone down. I don't want to make everyone so guilty about what they're eating and what they're wearing and what they're using. But it's something that we all should be conscious of. And the more conscious of it we become, the more better actions that we do, I think. And that's what I try to be as a vegan. You know, some days I'm not necessarily vegan. I'm a vegetarian, and some days I fail. Even that, you know, and that's being human. I think we're gonna make mistakes in this journey, no matter what you're trying to do, you know. But the thing is, we make an effort to be as knowledgeable or be aware of it as possible, and we make an effort to make that awareness count, so that we do the least amount of harm, the least amount of damage as possible. And that's always been, or not always been, but that's how my philosophy as a vegan has become to be developed. And that's why I'm continuing on 4 years straight and ongoing as a vegan. If you guys enjoyed, that was a very preachy kind of lecture video, but I just wanted to kind of blabber on about that. Cheers.